And hello everyone, and this is your hydraulic mechanics subject. And in this hydraulic mechanics subject series, the course code of this subject is ME317. Unit number 3 is running at the present time, and lecture number is 20. And today And topic and name is here for this today lecture is hydraulic circuit. And for my introduction, myself Rahul Kumar, assistant professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. And the hydraulic circuit. So for this hydraulic circuit, and this hydraulic circuit transmit and control power from a mechanical input to a mechanical output by means of a liquid. Here the power is transmitted from one place to any other place in the form of a liquid, and mostly for the liquid used as a oil. This is a hydraulic fluid, and power transmitted from one place to any other place by with the help of hydrostatically, where high pressure make static force denominate over dynamic forces, and energies is transmitted mostly through static pressure at low flow velocities. And this circuit are composed of a number of hydrostatic components, means this circuit made up of the different types of components, and which are connected to each other by means of piping, manifolds, are directly to enable transmission and control of the power or signals through liquids. Means the conclusion of this circuit is here, same as the electrical circuit. In the electrical circuit, where the electric current flows from switch to your electrical device. Similar in this hydraulic circuit, here fluid is flows with high pressure, and where the fluid is flows, this is called hydraulic lines and the hydrostatic components. And these hydrostatic components gives the direction, and the some component convert the output of the system, and all other things. So these are some objectives related to this topic. And by the end of this section, student and you should be able to understand about the hydraulic circuit. Means phenomena just like as a hydraulic circuit is a group of component such as pumps, actuators, control valves and conductors arranged so that they will perform a useful task. For the completion of this task, they will require some precaution measures, just like a safety of operation, performance of desired function and efficiency of operation. These are also include in this chapter for this lecture also, for the analysis of hydraulic circuits. And hydraulic circuit provide the various thing for the case of transmit the fluid from one place to any other place, right? So this slide shows the introduction of the hydraulic circuit. For the introduction of hydraulic circuit, this shows a one electric motor, and this electric motor connected to the hydraulic pump, and the hydraulic pump send the hydraulic power through the hydraulic valve with these two cylinders. These are the two cylinders with the two form of this. One is the hydraulic cylinder and another one is hydraulic motor. So this circuit shows a group of component including one or more pumps, actuators, valve, pipings and other equipment, and it is used for power transmission and control. So in this circuit, hydraulic motor, in this circuit, this is the electric motor drives the hydraulic pump, and hydraulic pump basically this is a one type of heart of the system of the hydraulic circuit, similar as the human body. This is the one heart is pumped to the blood for the whole body. And in the similarly, in the case of hydraulic circuit, hydraulic pump sends a fluid to the all component of the hydraulic system. So this is the one type of heart of the system is here. So for this hydraulic systems, and this type of hydraulic system are used in industrial and mobile. Applications to transmit power from a prime mover to operate machine parts or vehicles, right? Some stationary applications like tool mechanics, like presses, injection molding, and wherever heavy parts. Heavy parts need to be moved fast and precisely. Example for the outdoor applications are ship locks, are one of the best application for this hydraulic circuit is JCB cranes. This is the best example for the hydraulic circuit, and many other applications like as a die pressing operation. And this the die press operation gives the basic or fundamental information of the hydraulic circuit, and in this type of circuit you understand how to accomplish the hydraulic fluid work, and for this purpose we can use different types of pumps. These are the sometime it may be used positive displacement pump or the dynamic displacement pump. And dynamic displacement pump are used for the small force applications, but the positive displacement pump, this is a one type of rotary gear or the screw and piston types of pump which uses the different types of heavy load applications. In this slide I will discuss the different types of hydraulic circuits, and these hydraulic circuits these are the single acting hydraulic cylinder hydraulic control circuit, and the second one is double acting hydraulic cylinder control circuit, and next is regenerative cylinder circuit, and pump uploading circuit, and next is double pump circuit, next is counterbalance valve circuit, cylinder sequence circuit, and the locked cylinder using pilot check valves, and the cylinder synchronization circuit, and the fail safe circuits. Means these kinds of circuits I have discussed in this today lecture. So let's continue. The first is here single acting hydraulic cylinder control unit. In this slide shows the information regarding our circuit regarding the single acting hydraulic cylinder, and which control of here only single acting means the fluid goes inside single acting. First you know the what is the difference between single acting and the double acting cylinder. Means here only one ports, which cylinder have only one port. Means if you want to send the fluid inside the cylinder, so only this port is used, and if you want to back this fluid back from same ports, and this back same ports and gives to the goes to the reservoir, right? So this is a one kind of single acting cylinder, or cylinder, or we can say that this is a one type of actuators is here. So this control of single acting hydraulic cylinder gives the different types of component in the basic hydraulic systems, uses mainly few components, just like as a this is a what the symbol of this symbol. This symbol shows the fixed displacement pump. Displacement pump, it can be a gear type or a rotor type or any other types or a cylinder type of pump, but this shows a fixed type. If here is variable pump is given, then here one arrow is present here. Then that case arrow is present here. So this is a symbol of simple pump, and this is the filter. This shows the filter, and here the reservoir. Reservoir is downside. This is the reservoir of this pump, and this is the high pressure valve. This symbol shows the high pressure reducing valve. This symbol shows the pressure reducing valve, and this pressure reducing valve, one end connected to the high fluid pressurization line, and second end connect to the reservoir, right? So this arrow shows the fluid is moved from this to this side, and the fluid doesn't flow from reservoir to fluid lines. Always fluid flow from the only here to here, because in the pressure reducing valve, and this pressure reducing valve consists a spring loaded valve. So for this spring loaded valve, if any excess pressure inside this hydraulic fluid lines are in, sometimes this is closed. Suppose in this circuit is closed type. This circuit here is closed, right? And for this closed circuit, we suppose if this end is closed it here, and this is closed, if this end is closed, then the fluid hydraulic pump always pushes the liquid. It cannot stop in this during the operation of the hydraulic circuit, right? Hydraulic unit. So here this is a closed connection. So at this time, this creates a excess pressure inside the fluid line. This creates a excess pressure inside this fluid line. So this excess pressure goes through the at that time open this pressure reducing valve. Open the pressure reducing valve, and all the fluids which goes inside this hydraulic pipeline, this goes to the hydraulic pipe pressure reducing valve, and pressure reducing valve to the reservoir. So this is the one step for this hydraulic circuit. Then move to the another step. So for this another step, if you this is the control valve. This is the control valve of this circuit, right? And for this control valve, if you want to shift this system to this here, so at this time this is connected to here, and the fluid goes to the hydraulic cylinder, right? Single acting hydraulic cylinder, and then it moves the spring loaded valve. This is the piston is here, spring loaded piston is here present. Means this this is not a one design, this shows the spring loaded piston, right? For this case, if load is released, then this spring pushes this piston in the backward direction. So in this backward direction, this shows the unloading of the cylinder. For the loading case, if cylinder moves from the left to right, if cylinder moves from left to right, this is the loading condition of this hydraulic circuit. This is the loading condition of the hydraulic circuit. If cylinder moves from right to left, this is the unloading condition. So for the loading cylinder, this valve is shift to the right side, means this control valve shift to the right side, right side. And then for this case, the hydraulic fluid goes to the this line, and then actuator or this hydraulic cylinder moves to the left to right. If you want to again release the unit, so for this case you again shift the control valve in that position. This is the releasing condition case. So in this condition, all fluid which require the space inside the cylinder is as move to the control valve to the reservoir, right? So this is the one operation of the hydraulic system, or this is very simple operation about this system is here. So we move to the next slide. This is the operation of this single acting hydraulic cylinder. For this operation, in this spring offset mode, full pump flow goes to the tank via a pressure relief valve, and the spring in the rod end of the cylinder retracts the piston edge oil from the blank and drains back to the tank edge here. When the valve is manually actuated into the left envelope flow path configuration, pump flow extends the cylinder, and all the full extension pump flow goes through the relief valve. And for this purpose, at the time directional deactivation of the direction DCV, so the directional control valve, DCV, so the direction control valve allows this cylinder to retract as the direction control valve shift into its spring offset mode. So this is the operation of the single acting cylinder. So if then move to the double acting cylinder. For this figure, this is a double acting cylinder, and for the double acting cylinder, this is a alternate cycles of pressurized fluid to both side of the piston. Suppose if you want to pressurize this side of the piston, then you send the fluid from line to this side. So at that time, this type fluid is pressurized, and if you want to pressurize the fluid at this side, back side means right side, and this will give the pressurization at this time. So this type of cylinder is used in the some punching machine or different other types of in JCB also. This type of cylinder are used, and for the double type cylinder, and this type of cylinder creates pressure of the piston and retracts forces to move the piston rod, permitting more control over the movement, and it creates both side pressure. Means this is the left side and this is the right side. This piston divided into actuator into the two parts. This is the one side part and this is the next side part. So in this, and using a control system means we can say that control valve of this system, and here is control valve of this system is here. This is the control valve of the system. So for this control valve, just you create the different types of operations by shifting the control valve. Suppose at this position, unit is not running. Unit is not running because fluid doesn't send to the cylinder. Fluid does not send to the cylinder in this case, and all fluid goes pump by the creates a pressure by the pump, and this directly goes to the reservoir, and these port A and B both are shut down. Shut down means stationary, right? And this load, F load, is this is also stationary at this case. If you want to send the pressure or hydraulic fluid inside this actuating unit, so at that case you just move this control valve, and this control valve shift to the right side in this case, and this at this case the left side of this actuating unit, left side of the actuating unit, which is pressurized by the pressurized fluid, and this piston is moved in the left to right side. Piston is move at the left to right side means this side to this side. Piston is moved from left to right side, and similarly in the case of if you want to push this cylinder in the right left side, this is the cross side, cross type of, right? In this case this fluid goes to the reservoir, this line is A line is connected to the reservoir, and at that time B line means this B line pressurized by a fluid. So this is the return stroke of the cylinder. So at this condition the piston is moved from right to left side, then piston is moved from the right to left side. So this is the second movement of the piston. So from the conclusion of this cylinder is here, this cylinder work simultaneously forward and reverse stroke also, right? This cylinder works as a forward and reverse stroke also. So understand about the difference between single acting and double acting cylinder. In single acting cylinder only one side movement means one side pressurization fluid is possible, but in the double acting cylinder both side fluid is you send the both side fluid for the pressurization, right? For this case here is a if I am talking about the regarding the operation of the double acting hydraulic cylinder, for this case when the four way valve is in its tandem design, means this is the tandem design arrangement of the four way valve, and this cylinder is hydraulically locked, and also the pump is unloaded back to the at the essential atmospheric pressure, and when the four way valve is actuated into the flow path configuration of the left envelope, the cylinder is extended against its load force F load as oil is flows from port P through port A. Also oil in the rod end of the cylinder is free to flow back to the tank via the four-way valve at the port B. So here this is the port B is here. Note that the cylinder could not extend if the oil were not allowed to leave the rod end of the cylinder. When the four-way valve is deactivated, the spring-centered envelope prevails and the cylinder once again hydraulically locked at this condition, right? And suppose in this circuit, this shows the locking position of this cylinder, and at the end of this stroke, there is no system demand for oil. Thus, the pump flows goes through the relief valve and its pressure level setting unless the four-way valve is deactivated. If the system is protected from any cylinder overload, right? So this is the operation regarding this control of double acting cylinder. So we go to the next slide. For this next slide, this shows the regenerative cylinder circuit, and it is used to speed up the extending speed of a double acting, and this is the regenerative cylinder circuit, and this is used for the speed up the extending speed of the double acting hydraulic cylinder. So in this case, just you see here this is the different types of pressures, just like the QT equal to QP plus QR, and here is pressure is directly against the area. So in this side pressure is large and this side pressure is less, right? And here this area of this this type means this rod gives the less area of the piston. So this side pressure is large, and this if I am right side pressure gives the backward position at very fast speed of this piston, this actuating unit, right? If I am moving this control valve in this off position, right? And similar, this circuit is complete by the 4x3 control valve is used here, right? And for this total flow rate QT, total flow rate is here QT. Here the three types of the flow rate: QT, QR, and Q. And QT is the flow rate entering the blank end of the cylinder equals the pump flow rate Q is here plus the regenerative flow rate QR. Q means R represent the regenerative flow rate, and T is the total flow rate, and P is the pump flow, right? So the total QT is equal to QP plus QR. If we find the QP pump flow only, then you subtract the QT minus QR is here. This is a simple mathematics, and for the finding here total and QR also. So just I am telling in the last slide, this side is the fluid covers the more area, and here is fluid covers the less area. Means in this right side fluid covers the less area, and the left side fluid covers the large area. So for this case, we here gives a formula, and what is the formula is here? AP minus AR, this is the वीपी एग्जिट साइड, सो पी वीपी एग्जिट इक्वल टू क्यूपी डिवाइडेड बाय एआर इज हियर. सो ए स्मॉल रॉड एरिया प्रोड्यूसेस ए लार्ज एक्सटेंडिंग स्पीड, राइट. सो दिस इज द वन फार्मूला गिव्स द प्रेशर एट द आउटसाइड इन this is the pressure pressure this is a pressure and the next slide gives the information regarding ratio of extending and retracting speed. The ratio of extending and retracting speed is here. When extending and retracting speed are equal, then extending speed of the piston is vp exit equal to qp divided by ar. We know that the retracting speed Vp equals the pump flow rate divided by the difference of the piston and rod areas. Then V is the retracting speed is here equal to Qp divided by Ap in minus Ar. Then the ratio is here Vp exit minus V retracting equal to Ap divided by Ar minus 1. And this gives the speed equality condition. This gives the speed equality condition when the piston area equals to times of the rod area, and it gives the also the greater the ratio of the piston area to rod area, the greater of the ratio of extending speed and retracting speed, right. So this gives the information regarding this part. And next slide gives the information related to the force load carrying capacity during extension. So the this is the F load exit, it will give the P into A. Already you know force it gives the pressure into area. So the load carrying capacity of a regenerative cylinder during extension is less than the obtaining from the regular double acting cylinder. So the load carrying capacity F load for a regenerative cylinder during extension equals the pressure times the piston rod area rather than the pressure times piston area. So this is the information regarding double acting and single acting cylinders. For the pump unloading circuit, here this unloading valve is used here in this circuit. Suppose this is the one unloading valve is used to the unload a pump, and the unloading valve opens when the cylinder this valve opens when the cylinder reaches the end of its extension stroke and because of the check valve keeps high pressure oil in the pilot line of the unloading valve, and when the direction control valve is shifted, then this is the unit of the direction control valve means which is shifted to the retract the cylinder, and this is a unit of double acting cylinder. This is a unit of double acting cylinder, and the motion of the piston reduces the pressure in the pilot line of the unloading valve, and this retracts the unloading valve until the cylinder is fully retracted, at which point the unloading valve unloads the pump, and the unloading valve unloads the pump at the ends of the extending and retraction strokes as well as in the spring centered position of the direction control valve. And so this is a one type of case is here. Suppose if any excess pressure, then this cannot this is a unloading valve, this cannot gives a pressure excess pressure on the pump, right. And extra pressure or excess pressure inside this line, this goes through the pressure reducing valve and then reservoir of this line also. this circuit shows the hydraulic circuit just like as a double pump hydraulic system. Here in this circuit two pumps are used. Two pumps are used means this is the low flow pump and this is the high flow pump. One pump is used as a high flow pump and another pump is used as a low flow pump. For this purpose, in the high flow pump, here actuated unloading valves, right? And for this, this is a low flow pump. This is for a high pressure line, and this was the low pressure lines, right? Suppose high flow pumps, if velocity of the fluid is low, if the velocity of the fluid is low, then it creates a high pressure. If velocity of the fluid is high, then it creates a very large velocity of the flow is high, then it creates a less pressure compared to low flow pump. So this is the unloading valve is here. This is the unloading line and this is the symbol of reservoir. Here this symbol, this is a reservoir symbol. So here is one in this circuit pressure relief valve is connect and one unloading valve is connect here. This is also one pressure reducing valve, and here the control valve is used as a direction control valve. This is the 4x3 direction control valve, right? 4x3 means 2, 2, and 2, 2, four ports and three operations. It can provide the three operations, right? So this is a 4x3 control valve, and here the double acting cylinder is used. Here double acting cylinder is used for this case. So in this case the circuit uses a high pressure. High pressure and low flow pump in the conjunction with the low pressure high flow pump, right? This is a typical application in a sheet metal punch press. This is a one typical application for the sheet metal punch press, in which the hydraulic ram here, this cylinder gives the hydraulic ram operation. Cylinder, or we can say that sometimes it is called actuator, sometimes cylinder, sometimes actuating units, all are the same parts. So a typical application is a sheet metal punch press, in which the hydraulic ram must extend it rapidly over the great distance with very low pressure but high flow rate requirement, right? This rapid extension of the cylinder occurs under no external load as the punching tool, right? And this is connected to the end of the cylinder of this piston rod. So punch is connected to the end of the cylinder, right, end of this piston rod also, and approaches the sheet metal strip to be punched. So this is a very simple circuit, and this type of circuit used in this hydraulic punch machine. And you can see this type of circuit in this hydraulic punch machine in your workshop lab also. So you see this type of circuit, right? And second case is here. For the next slide, this is the case of counterbalance valve application. Counterbalance valve application. In this application, we can use this. This is a one hydraulic press. As this type of circuit used in hydraulic crane also. Hydraulic crane means one or two or three lifted, three lift crane, floor crane also. So here this is the load, and this is the actuating unit, right? And this is the two fully automatic means hydraulic circuit, right? So this type of circuit is used to purpose of counterbalance. and this unit CBV. Here one is unit is here CBV. This is the control counterbalance valve is here connector for the counterbalance valve, which set to operation to somewhat above the pressure required to prevent and the vertical cylinder from descending due to the weight of its load, right? Descending position. Suppose this is a downward position in the cylinder, and this permits the cylinder to be forced downward. When pressure is applied on the top, when the pressure is applied on the top, pressure is applied on the top, the open center directional control valve unloads the pump, and the direction control valve is a solenoid actuated spring centered valve, which is an open central flow path configuration, right? And this type of circuit is also used here. So then move to the next section of this lecture is here, and the next section for this lecture is here, MCQ problem. So for this MCQ problem, we will discuss in the next slide. This is your first MCQ problem, and which type of system uses oil under pressure means of power requirement. First is fluid power system, hydraulic system, pneumatic system, and stepper motor. So the B answer is right. So hydraulic system uses the oil under pressure always. So one question is B is the right answer for this one first question. The force developed in the hydraulic systems is due to high pressure more oil, less pressure, less oil. So the correct answer of this question is here, high pressure, right, is the correct answer. And move to the and which component of hydraulic system is used to store the sufficient amount of hydraulic oil? So first one is rotary pump, oil reservoir, flow control valve, and pressure gauge. So the component is here, oil reservoir is used to restore the sufficient amount of hydraulic oil, right? B is the right answer for this question. Then move to the next question. Most hydraulic circuits operates from central hydraulic power unit, use air over oil power units, heavy a dedicated power units, and does not have dedicated power unit. So the A is the correct answer for this question, right? So A means most of the hydraulic circuit operates from a central hydraulic power unit. And what pumps hydraulic oil to the hydraulic circuit? Flow control valve, oil reservoir, rotary pumps, and pressure gauge. So the correct answer of this question is here, A is the correct answer, flow control valves, right? Sixth question, the lubricator is an lubricator in an pneumatic circuit is the first element in line, second element in line, last element in line, and third element in line. The correct answer for this question is here, last element in line also. In the seventh question, it gives the what controls the direction of the flow of oil. Pressure relief valve, direction control valve, flow control valve, and actuator. The correct answer is here, direction control valve control the pressure direction of the flow of the oil. So the next question is here. It is the next question. What is the function of the flow control valve? Controls the direction of the flow of oil to pump hydraulic oil to the hydraulic circuit, and it converts the mechanical energy to hydraulic energy, and it controls the rate of flow. So B is the right answer, to pump hydraulic oil to the hydraulic circuit. So B is the right answer for this question. And then 9, and how many types of actuators are present in hydraulic system? 1, 2, 3, 4. So here is 2 actuators are present in the hydraulic circuit, hydraulic system, right? So B is the right answer for this question. For the 10th question, what is the function of pressure gauge? It controls the rate of flow of oil, it shows the pressure reading, controls the direction of the flow of oil, it converts the mechanical energy to hydraulic energy. So it converts the correct answer is it shows the pressure reading, right? So more to the references of this lecture. So thank you for this lecture, for kind of attention of this lecture is here. So these are the references for this lecture, and then if you have any question, and thank you for this lecture. Thank you.